This is Shanita, author of How to Have This and That. We are going to talk today about the law of abundance. 2 Corinthians 9:8, and God is able to bless you abundantly so that in all things, at all times, having all that you need, you will abound in every good work. That is one of the promises. The universe has been created in such a way that there is plenty of abundance everywhere. Abundance is truly all that exists. The entire universe is continually operating in this unwavering and unfailing fashion and knows no such thing as lack and limitation. The law of abundance is always at work. Although many perceive themselves to lack this abundance that flourishes throughout the world, the reality is that the law of abundance is always at work and always producing an abundance of something. The law of abundance is continually operating in your life all the time. The question is, what are you currently attracting an abundance of? What are you currently attracting an abundance of? Look at your life. Look in every area of your life. Do you have the kind of abundance that you desire in all areas of your life? If there is any lack, it is not because God has somehow failed you or that the law of abundance isn't working. The law of abundance is alive and well and continually producing with unwavering certainty an abundance of what you are choosing, just as intended. So what are you focusing your energy on most? Look at your life. The result of your focus is manifesting as your reality all around you. In fact, the law of abundance doesn't care and it doesn't cease to work. It's just constantly working. The question is, what do you have an abundance of? Health or illness? Money or lack of money? Happiness or sorrow? Prosperity or poverty? Remember, God is giving you an abundance of what you are choosing, what you are focusing your energy on. So, what are you choosing? What are you focusing your energy on? Think about that. The law of abundance abounds everywhere at all times. John 10:10, it says, I am come that they might have life and that they might have life more abundantly. If you're not personally experiencing the kind of abundance that you desire for yourself, there must be a reason. So what could that reason possibly be? Let's explore further to better understand how the law of abundance operates. It's important to understand that all things, both seen and unseen, is the result of your consciousness and your subconsciousness. Your thoughts, faith, emotion, focus, and the quality of your consciousness determines what you receive an abundance of. So what kind of seeds are you planting? Are they seeds of lack or prosperity? Are they seeds of health or illness? Are they seeds of happiness or sorrow? What are you planting in your conscious and subconscious mind, in the garden, in the soil of your subconscious mind? Based on the kind of and quality of these thoughts and feelings, which act as the seeds, the law of abundance has, does, and will continue without fail to determine the kind of quality of the abundance that you receive and is receiving based on the kind of quality of the seeds that you provide the law of abundance to work with for you. God wants to give us an abundance of our desires. There is always an abundance in the world. There is an abundance of lack and there's abundance of good things, plenty. But remember, if you are not getting what you want, ask yourself, what am I thinking of the most? What am I believing most of the time? What am I speaking most of the time? Remember, it all has to do with the quality of your conscious and subconscious, the quality of your thoughts and your feelings. What are you believing? What are you feeding your subconscious mind with? It is important to feed it with whatever you wish to manifest. If your thoughts, that is the seeds, are consistently focused on lack and limitation, well, you will have that because the law of abundance received the message of an abundance of lack and limitation in your life, and so it produces it for you. The law of abundance is consistently acting and producing in the exact and precise manner that it was designed to, by providing you with an abundance of whatever it is that you are focusing on the most. So if you're continually focusing on, say, thinking again, I'm a lack of money and material resources, well, of course, the law of abundance is at work providing you with an abundance of lack of money and resources. If your predominant thoughts are focused on lack of love in your relationships, this is exactly what you will be delivered to you. You will be provided with what you think about the most, what you feel most. If you are continually thinking about sickness and disease, I cannot emphasize enough that the law of abundance is at work providing you with exactly what you are thinking about the most. So every moment you are harvesting your seeds. Remember that. God wants to give us plenty of good things. You have a choice to focus on whatever it is that you want an abundance of. I want to emphasize that the law of abundance never rests or wavers and only produces an abundance of whatever seeds is provided to it to work with by you. Now, Buddha said, all that we are is the result of what we think. Proverbs 28:7, as a man thinketh, so he is. So the law of abundance produces an abundance of whatever you choose to think about the most. I'm going to emphasize this over and over again because that's the secret. The secret is to focus on what you want so that the universe can provide you with what you want. Whatever you choose for yourself, it will choose it for you. Let me remind you again that the law of abundance is always in action. Isn't it wonderful that life works that way? Yes, it is wonderful that life works that way. This is Shanita, author of How to Have This and That. My books are sold on Amazon. I'll see you on the beaches of the world.